Hey guys, the thing is, I just finished making footage about germane, where the main precursor was germanium tetrachloride, and before I upload it to the channel in few days, I'd like to show you a couple of reactions with germanium tetrachloride. By the way, that reaction in the community tab is a reaction of germane with silver nitrate solution. Nobody guessed the reaction. Germanium tetrachloride represents a colorless caustic liquid. Unlike other liquid tetrachlorides, such as vanadium, titanium, silicon and tin, germanium tetrachloride fumes much more weakly in humid atmosphere. This chemical is the result of heating elemental germanium in chlorine flow. I didn't drain chlorine for this reaction, so that it would be possible to see germanium tetrachloride forming. See that white smoke that's forming in the reaction area? That's the vapors of germanium tetrachloride that react with the moisture of air, forming white germanium dioxide. And this is what will happen if we add liquid chlorine to heated germanium. Adding germanium tetrachloride in water causes its hydrolysis with the formation of germanium dioxide. Well, to be more precise, it's not an oxide that's forming, but a hydrated oxide, and it gets calcinated in order to get pure germanium dioxide. Germanium dioxide is an amphoteric oxide. It is easily soluble in a concentrated alkali solution with the formation of potassium hexahydroxygermanate. Potassium iodide is very sensitive to germanium tetrachloride vapors. You can see potassium iodide turn yellow even before it touches a drop of the reagent. This is a reaction with the formation of another germanium halide, that is tetraiodide. Germanium tetraiodide represents an orange-brown powder. When heated, it decomposes into iodine and germanium diiodide. Catalyzed into chloride crystals slowly turn it into germanium tetrachloride, even at room temperature. When heated at a temperature above 80 degrees Celsius, concentrated sulfuric acid is able to oxidize germanium tetraiodide to elemental iodine. I could not find a reaction equation describing this process, so try to write the equation for this reaction in the comments. And a very interesting reaction with germanium tetrachloride occurs when it interacts with lithium aluminum hydride in dry diethyl ether. We'll take a closer look at this reaction in the next video, so don't forget to subscribe to make sure you won't miss that one or many other cool chemical videos. See you there!